I'm Earl Stewart. I welcome you to Earl Stewart on Cars Mystery Shopping Report. The mystery shop was Arrigo, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep. The Arrigo brothers, John and Jim, you've seen their commercials, and they're hysterical, and they're entertaining, and I compliment them. At any rate, they sold all their dealerships to Larry Morgan Auto Group, and they've acquired a large auto group. Morgan continued to operate his new acquisitions under the Arrigo brand. Thankfully for us, we still get to see Jimmy and Johnny Arrigo cutting it up in their commercials.
Johnny, why are you dressed like that?
I just signed Arrigo's declaration of low prices.
Great. Now go mark down all 2,500 new vehicles.
I hope my quill has enough ink.
Declare independence from high prices all month long at Arrigo. Get new Ram 1500s from $249 per month. Grand Cherokees from $259 a month. Plus, Arrigo needs your trade. So make this the summer event you can't miss.
I do declare I am done.
By George, he's got a future car sale.
You got to go Arrigo.
You got to love that, right? I mean,
I'm telling you.
They're pros.
Now that nearly years passed, we're pretty sure Morgan's Arrigo has had the needed time to settle into their groove. So we called up Agent Lightning for her encore. And here's the report. Arrived in the evening, I'm speaking as if I were a female shopper, Agent Lightning. I arrived in the evening around 6 o'clock. I entered the showroom and was greeted by a woman seated at the front desk. She asked how she could help me, and I told her I was interested in a new 2021 Dodge Ram. I'd seen it online. The woman looked puzzled and said she needed to check to see if they carry those. I mean, obviously, first day on the job. She turned her attention to another woman standing nearby. Melissa, do we carry Dodge Rams at this location? She asked. Melissa laughed and said they carried Dodge Rams. They had a bunch of them in stock right now. She walked over to me, and she's a salesperson, obviously, introduced herself. I showed her the online listing for their truck. The MSRP was $46,075, and the Arrigo price was $39,989. Ooh.
What a deal.
What a deal. Now, here we are in the pandemic, high demand, low supply, microchip shortage. Cars are selling two-thirds or more over sticker, and Arrigo's online price is $39,989, which is
$6,000.
Yeah. Over about $6,000 less. That's a hell of a deal.
Yeah.
Melissa wrote down the stock number, and then she'd go check and see if it was available. I'm thinking, probably ain't going to be here, but she asked me to wait and walked off. She was back in 3 minutes with the keys and said it was my lucky day. Oh, yeah. Melissa asked me to follow her to the desk where she could get some information, you know, the shtick. We sat down, went through the ritual. When she finished, Melissa asked for my driver's license. I handed it over, and then she asked if I was planning to finance my truck. I said I intended to pick cash, but I'd entertain financing if there were some compelling incentives. We went outside. Melissa had a hard time finding the vehicle. I waited only a few minutes before Melissa drove up to the truck, honking joyfully. It was the same truck I'd found online, same VIN. She checked that. Same MSRP. And this is very important, folks. Always, always shop and compare apples and apples. Same MSRP. There was also an addendum, of course, next to the Monroney label, a.k.a. Phony Monroney. Same Arrigo Advantage package. And boy, do they have a bunch of stuff on there. It's totally worthless. $1,995, can I say $2,000?
Hey, let's round up.
Worth of junk. Melissa popped the hood. We looked at the engine. She described all the technical specs to me perfectly while we looked at the monolith. She opened all the doors and continued to go over all the features. Melissa handed me the key. We took it on a test drive. I asked her why I should choose the Dodge Ram over its competitors. Melissa gave me a very diplomatic and, I thought, honest answer. She said she did not believe in bashing the competition. Refreshing. Mm-hmm. Or overhyping her brand, also refreshing. She told me that all the trucks in Ram's class were very good. Each had the advantages and disadvantages. That's honest, scary honest, right? I took a U-turn, headed back down to the dealership, back at the desk. Melissa asked if I was ready to move forward. I said I was, but cautioned that I would not allow my credit to be run because I was planning to pay cash. She told me that she was fine and assured me she would advocate for me and make the process easy. Melissa went to get the numbers. She was back in 8 minutes with a worksheet. Top line labeled market value selling price was MSRP 46,075. There was an $1,186 discount and then a $3,500 rebate. This made the adjusted group price 41,389. Then came, here we go. Here comes the funny business, folks. $1,995 Arrigo Advantage. And even though Arrigo doesn't own the place, it's still called the Arrigo Advantage. A $998 dock fee, that's a dealer fee, hidden fee. $380.50 in taxable fees, also a hidden fee, dealer fee. My real price was $46,766, and that's $691 over MSRP, but the advertised price was $6,000 under MSRP. I hope Larry Morgan and his son are listening. See, it's illegal to advertise a price below what you'll sell the car for. But everybody does it. But the law doesn't recognize that just because everybody does it. It's just because the law is not doing the job enforcing the law. I told Melissa I do not want the Arrigo Advantage package and said the price they had in line was much less. She replied that the price included rebates I didn't qualify for, and that's not right or legal either. And this really made me mad when she said this, a first responders rebate? I mean, that's really below the belt. Pandemic, crisis, first responders. How many people come in the door, first responders? Are you a fireman? Are you a policeman? That's just not right. I protested that I did not see anything about that in the listing, and there wasn't, even in the fine print. Melissa asked for a moment to confer with her manager, left the desk. She's back quickly and told me her manager wanted to make sure I understood that I was already getting $3,500 in rebate. Yeah, for if I'm a fireman. And he had no more room to go on the price. I stood up, thanked Melissa for her time. I told her this was all bait and switch. Melissa pled with me to stay so I could meet her sales manager. I said no. And I left. As I was approaching my car,
Here it comes.
Melissa ran out to say that her manager agreed to take off another $2,000 if I signed in tonight. I kept walking, I laughed, and I got into my car. How sweet it is.
They tried they called that the parking lot save.
The parking lot save. And the manager was too damn lazy to run out himself. He said, hey, run out and get her. Okay, it's voting time on Arrigo, Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge.
I'm going to give them a D.
I'm going to agree with that D.
Nancy, what are your voters?
I give them a D minus.
I'm going to make it a D. I'm going to give them I'm giving you a break because I like Larry Morgan. When you advertise a car today with a first responders rebate that you don't disclose, that's hitting below the belt.
Yep.
And that really lowered you in my estimate and the way I would vote. But next time, I'm going to fail you if you don't fix this. This is Earl Stewart. Thank you for watching this video. If you would like to be notified of new videos that we post to our YouTube channel, simply click on the subscribe button at the lower right-hand side of the screen.